welcome to our table.
Thank you. I think it's the best table in the room.
It is.
It's
gotta be.
Yeah. Eight ladies and a dude, we call this table.
Exactly.
So, so Caroline, we were totally left hanging, and you were not left hanging. You were left on the ground.
Oh, yes.
What do you think we might see next season without giving too much away?
I don't even have anything to give away because I really don't know. But I've been talking to Brian today. He gave me a few pointers in what direction we're going. I know that with everything that's happened to her in season two, she has to be a changed woman, or else she will just quit it off. But she's not the kind that will quit. So I know that she probably carries a lot of shock still and guilt from what happened, and will probably want to change her way of working or her perspective on what she does. I really don't know what's going to happen. I don't know what state she's going to be in,
like physically as well.
But we do start a year after,
right?
So maybe she'll have healed a little bit. Maybe she'll be dead and be arriving at some
idol. I thought you had a lot of, like, you were a very active character. You know, you weren't just standing by and you were moving around a lot. If you're injured, that would be difficult to play that same kind of role. So
yeah.
Do you enjoy, like, how do you see your part in the whole cast changing, and do you enjoy how it's developed over the time so far?
That's a big question. I don't even know where to start. Well, you know, in season one, she was the only one who made sure Will was going to be okay. He was put into very dark, dark places, and no one seemed to really care, but really make sure that he was going to be healthy through that whole process. In season two, she was not caught between two men, but, you know, she was, I think, very protective and disappointed with what happened with Will, and knowing that she always wants to protect him. It's been a big day.
Sorry.
Yeah, knowing that she always wants to fix a man, probably, or save a man, would be a better word. She actually says it in the second episode, I want to save you. I think Hannibal was the rock that she knew she had never been with a man that was she didn't need to save. So I think it was a grown-up relationship in her mind, but maybe not completely heartfelt. And so I think in season three she will be a lot harder, which will be fun to play. But that's what I think is going to happen. But God knows if Brian's going to go in that direction.
Because
it feels like we're making a cable show on the floor. It's getting those numbers. Yeah, I think they have to sometimes dial down the redness of the story, but we are getting what we want. So, that's what we need to do to tell the story properly. And if NBC wants to tell the story properly. So they've been cooperating.
Yeah. Like filming that scene. A lot of probably have more of an emotional, really hard time during the process, more so than Will. So for the season finale, how was it trying to, get into that character filming that scene?
What scene are you talking about?
When she finds out that Hannibal is in fact the serial killer, and then in the end, you are
out the window.
Uninterpreted,
defenestrated. You are defenestrated through the window.
I think she was in complete shock. I can't even imagine going through that, how your brain must go to try to grasp what just happened to you. And also, I think that scene is beautiful. She explains that the black ink is getting inside her, like she's being poisoned. Every orifice, every pore in her body is feeling it come in. I think that's probably what a victim feels like when they've been this close to death. So what was your question?
Yeah, that was it.
Yeah, that's right.
I thought I was
going like
you
this.
Did good, yeah.
Wait. Do you know when you're going to start shooting? I think we start somewhere in October. the beginning is going to be mostly about Hannibal and what he's up to a year after when he's left us.
I was just reading it, said on the panel that season 3 is going to be sort of season 3, not even more.
Yes. Yeah, I think the first part will be about what happened, and after that will be more like right back at the starting.
So a fun question for you.
Hey.
Do you think that Alana will keep adopting dogs, and what would you name them?
I don't know. We got applesauce from a fan.
That's pretty neat.
It's cute, isn't it?
It is. It's a good
little name.
It's
a good name.
Yeah.
I wish I had that idea for a dog. I don't know if she's going to. Maybe. She ought to get really, like, protective dogs.
Therapy dogs, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Guard dogs, yeah. I would say. Yeah.
So what would you name one if you had the chance? If Brian let you name your own dog, would you, if you got another one?
My God. That would need some time to come up with something really interesting. Nothing's popping up. Maybe Comic-Con. We can name the dog Comic-Con.
There you go.
The dog
a little comedy
complex
in her life.
Right.
Yeah. Let's name the dog.
An homage to the fans, you know, I guess. So.
Yeah.
How much input have you had into maybe certain personality traits or certain aspects of the character that were more from you and not just directions given to you about how to play her?
Well, Brian is open when we receive the scenes and there's something that we don't get or something that we don't feel our character would do. He's open to hearing us and adjusting so that we feel comfortable. So things like that have happened. I think everyone's been felt confident that they could write Brian. I don't know if I have a specific example. I don't have a specific example, but I remember when we were doing the scene in bed with Bess, and they were talking about the funeral and how sex can sometimes, you can feel the need for it after a funeral. I remember having that conversation with Brian and saying, I think that came from a conversation that we had together. You know, I said, it feels almost like the need to be alive after death, you know,
mm-hmm.
after being so close to death, and I think that made its way into the script. So,
that's really
things like that happened.
Having worked with Brian on Wonderful, how has that changed? How has he changed? How has your work with him changed?
On Wonderful was co-created by Brian and Colin. So the two of them created the whole thing, and then he had a lot of writers. So Brian was there, but it wasn't like he's writing almost every episode. It's really his baby. So I'm getting to see Brian. Emailing them much more on Hannibal than I did on Wonderful.
I think that might be it. Thank you so
much.
Thank you so much. Great rest of the con.
Thank you.
The con? Is that right?
The con.
Yes, the con.